Hello, welcome to Pumpkin Kitty Nighttime Clinic. Sign in. How may I help you this evening? Yes? Okay. Having a bit of trouble falling asleep. And you'd like to book in? Well, I can certainly help you out with that. Could I just grab a few details from you first, if that's okay? Perfect. Could I grab your name? Your middle initial and your last name, please. Perfect. And could I grab your date of birth? Okay, thank you. Great. And could I grab your home address, please? Perfect. Yep, got that. You haven't been here before with us, have you?
No.
It's your first time. And would you like to be seen in the evening or during the daytime? So night or day, would you like to be seen by our specialist? Yeah, we can do after your dinner time. So when approximately is your dinner time? About 6 to 7 o'clock? Yep, let me check. What day would you prefer? A Friday? Just check my calendar. Okay. So we have one spot at 8 o'clock with Kitty. Yeah. Would that be alright with you? 8 o'clock with Dr. Kitty be okay? That should give you plenty of time to have your dinner and get prepared. And please be sure to wear your pajamas, as it is an evening visit. You will need to stay overnight. We don't like people driving home in the evening visits, because sometimes they just fall asleep. So we always tell people to plan to stay the night for the evening time. Is it alright with you? Perfect. Yep. Booking that in now for you. Great. So that'll be on Friday at 8 p.m. Dr. Kitty. Just send a confirmation email. Can I have your email address, please? Perfect. So I'll send you that confirmation. Great. You should get that anytime now. And I'll also send one to the doctor. Great, now can I have a little bit more detail about what you're struggling with at night time? Like, is it like overthinking too much? Just can't get relaxed? A bit of both? That's completely normal. A lot of our patients have a bit of both. It is very rare when one and the other sort of work separately. It's mainly a lot of overthinking and a lot of just restlessness, which happens. Yeah. But don't worry, we'll be able to help you out. No worries at all. Now, do you have any medical history that we should be aware of? So I can put it on your file. Okay. Yep, I got all that. And what is your normal doctor? I'm only asking because sometimes we need to ask for their records. So, just in case. Don't worry, it's nothing bad. Just need for our records. And your regular GP will be getting a letter or an email from us just about this visit, so they can also be aware. Yeah. It's just protocol. Now let me see if I've got them in our file in our system. There they are. Perfect. All right. So my morning team will get onto the letter to your doctor. In the meantime, I will shoot them a quick email. So, in the morning, they'll get that email, and you'll be right to go. They might call you in for an appointment just to make sure that everything's okay, and if you're on any medication that could be affecting your sleep, just so they're also in the loop. Yeah. Some medication can. I know some patients of ours have been on certain medications, like even Panadol, has kept some patients very, very alert at night time. Yeah, you wouldn't think about it, but yeah, just something even as simple as over-the-counter Panadol can cause some people to keep awake at night time. But that's why the doctor just needs to be kept in the loop. Would you be bringing anyone with you on the day? Sometimes some people like to have a support person with them. You can have a support person, but we only allowed one support person due to the fact that it is meant to be a restful and peaceful place, environment, so we don't want to have too many people crowding the one room while you're with the doctor. Just yourself. Great. And also, will you be bringing in any comfort things like blankets or a soft teddy or a favorite pillow of yours? We supply pillows and blankets for the beds for the evening patients, but you can choose to bring your own pillow, your own blanket. Whatever helps you relax, bring along. So off the top of your head, do you think you will be bringing anything along? You do? Yep. Of course you can bring that. Like I said, whatever helps you relax, feel free to bring along. I just hooked my cable. Okay, let me see. Now, you will be getting a confirmation email. You've got that. You just got the notification for that. Perfect. You will also be receiving a letter in the post, just so you can have a paper form. Sometimes we find our patients like to have notices stuck up on the fridge or on a board or on a wall at home, just to remind them Because I know even myself, I do tend to forget something sometimes. Unless it's stuck up on the fridge. Yeah. Can we also get... I didn't. I forgot to grab your phone number. Can I please grab your best mobile contact number? Great. So, would you like a text message to be sent out as well? Just a reminder, the day before. You would. Yes, right. I'll opt you in for that. And don't worry, we don't give out your email address or phone number to anyone at all. It's all kept safe and confidential in our system. Now, I know this is a bit jumping all over the place. Our system is a bit blur at the moment. So, having some technical issues. Okay. So, is there anything you're allergic to? Like any, as in your oils you're allergic to? Or any sort of perfume smells that sort of flare you up or something? Sometimes our doctors will be using essential oils and different smells just to help relax and calm the environment down. Sometimes they will use I forgot what they're called. Incense sticks. Yeah. So we have to ask if anyone's allergic to certain smells, like sometimes smells can flare people up. Oils, sometimes people get affected by oils. Yeah, just general, if you're allergic to them three things, anything like that. Okay. Okay. Just gonna write a few notes now. Bear with me a moment, please. If you have any questions, feel free to ask while I'm writing your notes down for you. Yes. Sometimes people do need more than one visit. Our doctor, on the day or the night of your appointment, will decide that for you if you do need to come for an extra visit. No, you don't have to call back up to get another appointment for an extra visit. No, just go to the front desk once you're done. So in your case, you'll be done in the morning. So you just need to go to the front desk and hand the reception the piece of paper that the doctor gives you at the end of your appointment, and you are free to go. And your next one will be set up for you. Yeah, easy. We'll try to make this process as easy as possible for everyone. Mm-hmm. Is there anything else you'd like to know or you're interested in? So yeah, so in the letter, it will remind you about wearing your pajamas because you are an evening patient. You'll be asked to wear your pajamas, asked to have your dinner before your appointment. At least half an hour to an hour before your appointment, you must eat your tea. Just because if you're asked to lay down, you can lay down comfortably and you don't have to worry about that awkward full stomach feeling after dinner. And bring your water bottle and your comfort, whatever the comfort is. Remember what the comfort was like. A teddy, a blanket, a pillow, just anything that helps you relax. Please, no mobile phones are allowed. If you do bring your phone, please leave it with reception. Yeah, phones can be very distracting and can actually also be a cause for sleeping issues. Yeah. It's amazing what things can be sleeping issues. Looks like we're all done here. Got all that. Got all that. That's all good. Good. Just double checking everything. All good on my end. Okay. Fantastic. So we'll see you on Friday at 8 o'clock. Great. I'm so glad I can help. No worries. We'll see you then.